Fans, at this time, we ask that you please rise as we honor America and the Purple Pride Pep Band, under the direction of Patrick Murphy, plays our national anthem.
Hello and welcome to the Palace on the Bluff, the Child Center, where the Portland Pilots are going to take on number 15 ranked Washington. I'm Cody Barton here with Allison Sievers, and Allison returning to the Bluff for the first time this season. Portland's got to deal with a lot of factors, one of those being Kelsey Plum.
Yeah, Kelsey Plum's coming in, one of the top three-point shooters in the nation right now. UW leads the country in threes. So it's going to be a big, huge key for us to slow her down.
Yeah, averaging 30 points a game for the Huskies, who were 5-1. They defeated Seattle U last night in Seattle. They're going to play the Portland Pilots in a back-to-back for them before they go on the road to Grand Canyon. And then they have a big homestand through the month of December before starting conference play. And then for the Portland Pilots, you've got a home game against Portland State on Wednesday, and then they're on the road until December 11th against Montana State. But first, the keys for Portland, the player to watch, Holly Blades. And Allison, she comes off this huge three-point shooting performance, tying a program record.
Yeah, great, great performance up in Alaska, ties a record that was actually set by Jen Wassum, who's on the coaching staff at Washington this year. Got to keep him off the threes. Catch and transition.
Yeah, and Holly Blades is just really, she's coming into her own, a college transfer from the College of South Idaho. And now we'll go into the keys to the game. And Allison, you're just talking about it. The Portland Pilots have to defend the three-point line and not allow this Husky team to get set shots around the perimeter.
Yeah, it's important to catch them. They're getting the ball on the move, as Coach Cheryl said before the game. It's a big key to the game tonight.
And then Osahor off the boards. She's been a fixture around the rim all season long. First points for the Portland Pilots. So Turley, Portland Pilots are going to be in man-to-man as well. Got to keep themselves active around the perimeter. Collier. Out of bounds to Portland. So you have Spencer there battling Osahor around the rim. And first segment of that is a draw as UW with a fresh 30. Plum gets it deflected, 23 on the shot clock, swinging it around Romeo, and it's good. And so there's another set three-pointer for the Huskies. Turley, looking at Gray. Gray calling for it just a couple feet off the block. Collects herself, in and out, and rebound Huskies, and they're on the run. Coral goes baseline, runs into a double team. Swung around. Romeo to Plum, set shot. No good, and Julie Spencer with the rebound. The sophomore from Chehalis, Washington will have her work cut out for her, and up and under from Turley, no good. And here's UW. They're going to push this pace. They average 89 points a game. Coral for three.
Heather Corral for three.
And so for Washington, back-to-back three-pointers, extending this game out. Van Loo. There's Blades, catch, release, off the back of the rim. Here's Plum. Mixing it up, takes it all the way to the hole, and one. Simply divine play from Kelsey Plum, showing why she's one of the best players in the nation.
It was good for Plum. Violence foul was on number three, Haley Van.
She just kind of muscles her way in there, Allison. I mean, that's something that you don't see a lot in the women's game.
Yeah, she's an aggressive player. She's top player in the nation, man. She's fun to watch. Pilots got to stop her early.
So here's Van Loo. She's going to run off the double pick. Julie Spencer from long range. No good. Osahor with the rebound for UW. Plum on the run yet again. Leaving Turley on an island. Swinging it out to Romeo. Rebound Van Loo. So Portland Pilots have kind of matched pace here, but then they're not really attacking in transition as of yet. Blades pulling up from 15, short. Loose ball, Osahor gets it for UW, and she's running the floor. Going coast to coast, Collier there with the rebound, and Ashley Gray finally comes away with it for the Portland Pilots. So now Van Loo is going to slow things down for Portland.
This was a key that Coach Cheryl was talking about early in the before the game, that if Portland can get teams to play defense for longer than 10, 15 seconds, they're really getting into the flow of their offense, and it's turned out to be good for the Pilots.
Plum again will go to the free throw line, draws the contact from Turley. So we look at this replay here again, and Plum has no problems going, attacking with her left.
It's a good free throw shooter, too.
Yeah, shooting 90% on the season. So almost automatic. And she'll get both of them. So a 10-2 Huskies lead. Almost halfway through this first quarter. Portland Pilots trying to get organized into their offense. Anderson, who has checked into the game for the first time for the Portland Pilots, up under from Van Loo, no good.
Nice hustle by Gray there to get in there and try to get that board.
And so that'll bring us into the media timeout. It's 10-2 Huskies lead and possession when we come back. 5:54 remaining in the first quarter here at the Child Center. You have the Washington Huskies ranked number 15 in the land with a 10-2 lead early here. And Allison, we've seen they've been getting it done around the perimeter and in transition.
Yeah, big threes, but a lot of those threes are coming with their feet set, and a big thing that Coach Cheryl said that they didn't want at the beginning of the game. So I think both teams are running the floor. Pilots look a little tired, but hopefully that media got some legs ready to go.
So you've got Van Loo now. Anderson dishes off to Ashley Gray, who draws the contact and will get two shots from the charity stripe for her troubles.
It's fun to watch Anderson out there. Coached against her the last few years at Jesuit, so fun to see a local kid out here.
And she got the call in early. Blades taking a seat right now.
Checking into the game.
Ashley Gray getting that first free throw.
Ashley Gray at the line for the Pilots.
Shooting 72% for the year. And she'll go 2 of 2. So Portland Pilots at least taking care of little things. Not too many turnovers. No turnovers on the board yet for the Portland Pilots. Osahor. Going around Julie Spencer. That's going to happen. Right now for Portland, there's just this man-to-man defense. Everybody has to do their job. And when you're playing a nationally ranked team like this, some stuff breaks down.
Checking into the game for the Pilots, number 30.
With Chantel, she shoots 78% from 15 feet. Gets the first. And she'll go 2 of 2. So both teams taking care of fundamentals at the Child Center, and that's given Washington an 8-point lead. Slega into the game.
On the boards.
Was on number 40.
Yeah, 5 rebounds for number 0. And then she's done a really good job, too, splitting any type of defenders around the perimeter. And she completes 3 the old-fashioned way. So here's Van Loo, Slega. Into Anderson. Up and under, sent back, and it'll be out on the Portland Pilots. So you've got Henson in for UW as well now. And here's Plum. Into Johnson. Romeo off the back of the rim. Johnson with the offensive board. Plum. Little two-man basketball in and around the key for UW. Johnson can't finish. And so now there's that long pass from Portland as they try to push the ball. Julie Spencer asking for it on the block.
Oh, great
big
move.
And they call an offensive foul.
Tough break there by for Spencer. She's working her butt off down on the defensive end.
So yeah, you see her, she leaves that left arm. The spin move was okay, the fake to the inside, then go to the baseline side. Perfectly fine, but trying to clear out some space and got caught. So Portland without a field goal for the last 6 minutes, 20 seconds. Plum skying baseline, can't get it to fall. And here's Van Loo. Zaragoza into the game for the first time for Portland. Post move, fundamentals off the glass, no good. UW with the rebound, Plum to push. Romeo. Short from Plum, and now we're going back the other way. So Portland trying to find the bottom of the net. Carrington, no good.
Nothing wants to drop for the Pilots. Some great moves downside.
Romeo pulls up for three. And now it's an 18-4 University of Washington advantage. And now Portland hasn't scored in the last 3.5 minutes. Goes to Slega and one.
Basket's good for Darian Slega.
So Darian Slega off the bench. This is what she does best, where she just can get ahead of steam and attacks the key. Uses the glass to put it home for Portland, and she'll have a chance to get the three-point play.
I think this is a place where the Pilots can be successful, attacking the rim and drawing fouls and getting to that free throw line.
And no good there from Slega. So it's a 12-point Husky advantage. Plum, backdoor cut. And there'll be a foul before the shot. Oh, and I guess they're going to give it to her. So they'll give, I guess we got continuation here, the NCAA level. Getting the star treatment here. And so Plum with a rare miss. Swinging around, here's Van Loo. Zaragoza asking for it yet again. Good defense from UW. Slega, short. Plum running with it. Again, this UW team absolutely relentless with their pace. Osahor, long. Carrington with the rebound for Portland, the sophomore from Dublin, California. Zaragoza clears out some space. Tries to find the block, no good. And now shot clock's off as UW will hold for last possession. Plum. And wide open in the corner is Henson, and makes Portland pay.
A little bit of a breakdown there defensively for the Pilots. Miscommunication.
So that'll bring us the end of the first quarter. The Huskies 23, the Pilots 8. We'll have more basketball and a breakdown of the first quarter when we return. Go over to the scores table, talk things over. Mike Neighbors
ruthless. He just got this lead here, and he wants the Portland Pilots to earn every possession.
Call of the court was that it will be a jump ball, so Pilots will inbound.
So Portland Pilot possession off the jump ball. Alternating possession rule. Van Loo gets a screen from Gray, doesn't take it. Instead will drive baseline, finds Blaze in the corner. Off the top of the backboard, five on the shot clock. Slega attacks, loses control. Zaragoza got to throw it up. No good, off the rim, rebound, UW.
It's a great find by Van Loo, unlucky shot by Blades.
Again, Holly Blaze, you live by the three, die by the three.
Shoot or shoot, she'll find one.
And the Portland Pilots, good double team underneath against Osahor. So here's Van Loo. You got Van Loo to Slega. Blades coming off the screen, defended by Henson. Slega pulls up from the elbow, short. Rebound Johnson. Plum thought about it. Osahor left up top, in and out. Rebound goes to Van Loo. Good to see your point guard getting involved in the defensive boards.
Yeah.
Zaragoza can't finish off the glass. Ashley Gray tries to come in and snag the offensive rebound. No can do. Plum pushing in for UW. Pulls back, 3 feet behind the arc, no good. Slega. Again, Gray setting that screen. Kind of a horn action from UP, and Slega. Set shot from the 45. Puts Portland in double digits. Dribble drive from Plum. Henson. Back to Plum. Johnson from the corner, no good. And we'll have a foul. And the Osahor with the personal, her first.
Foul is charged to the Huskies, number zero. That's her first.
And so first. Julie Spencer back in, Hannah Matson in for the first time as well, the senior from Fairbanks, Alaska.
And number 23, Julie Spencer.
Dribble drive, Anderson. Matson puts it on the floor. Spencer, 15 feet. Off the back of the rim, no good. Osahor with the rebound out to Melgoza. Melgoza, one-on-one. And the charge taken by Kaylee Van Loo. Van Loo has done everything right for the Portland Pilots so far.
She's a huge factor for this Pilot team. She's a great leader on the floor. Quite the general out there.
So a 12-point Husky lead. Portland would like to get this down to 10 or even single digits. Van Loo thought about it. Going against Plum. Into the key. Matson. 10 on the shot clock. Anderson. Running baseline, now dribble drive, lays off to Ashley Gray, who can't finish. It'll stay here. So the Portland Pilots with a fresh 30. Here's Van Loo, Anderson, plenty of time, short. Johnson with a rebound for the Huskies. Plum working off the Johnson screen, pick and pop into Osahor. Dribble drive, left hand finish. Anderson, the freshman, getting aggressive for Portland. Ashley Gray Sliding across, Mattson has some space off the back of the rim. Julie Spencer can't get there in time, and so the Huskies with some mass substitutions here to take us
into the game for the Huskies, number 34, Deja Struther.
With basically a whole new lineup, a lot of the starters returning for UW.
And number 5, Natalie Romeo.
So the Plum, Romeo, Collier, Coral, and Strother checking in for the first time for the Huskies. Tries to find Collier, no good. So Strother with their first touch of the game with the turnover. Portland again, plenty of opportunities here to just whittle away at this lead. But they're 0 for their last four from the field. They haven't scored in the last 2 minutes. Spencer with the soft touch. So breaking that scoring drought for Portland, who's really gotten things done in the defensive end in this second quarter. And then the good deny defense from Hannah Mattson on the perimeter forces the travel.
Great defense by the Pilots here. Finding good shots, things aren't falling. Hopefully we catch a break here after Spencer's bucket.
And an unforced turnover from the Portland Pilots gives it right back.
Timeout on the floor.
And that'll take us into the media timeout. 25-13 Washington advantage. When we return.
Enjoy an ice cold Coke or Diet Coke. Coca-Cola, open after. Coca-Cola, the proud partner of Pilot Athletics.
Back here at the Child Center, there's Mike Neighbors in his fourth season for the University of Washington Huskies, who have a 12-point lead right now. And Allison, we're looking, just take a look back at the keys for the game. Portland's done pretty good on the defensive end, but they need to keep Osahora off the boards.
Yeah, I agree. She's a big presence in there. She's cleaning up the boards, but I think the Pilots are playing great defense right now, especially this quarter. I'm just hoping that can turn into some offense on the other end.
Yeah, Portland has held UW to 28% from the field, 27% from beyond the arc. And when you look at them just as a season tally, this UW team usually just shoots a hair under 50% from the field. Strother can't get it to fall for UW from the perimeter. But Osahor with 9 rebounds, and that is a problem Portland needs to fix around the hoop. Right now she's taking a break. Anderson, Van Loo, Mattson, catch, release, and she'll shoot 3.
Huskies foul on number 14, Heather Corral.
So Coral with the foul.
Hannah Mattson at the line for the Pilots to shoot.
For you, dumb. So Hannah Matson's going to shoot 3. A real opportunity for Portland to get this within single digits. So Hannah Mattson, so you just see the swing play here. gets into it, and then just the over pursuit from UW. But Madsen, only her third and fourth and then fifth free throws respectively coming up.
Sarah Zaragoza, she replaces Spencer.
So Madsen improves to 3-5 on the season from the stripe. And Portland within 10. You see this Portland team's kind of settled down. Cheryl Sorensen not afraid to go to the bench to find some stability in this game. Find some players who can keep pace with this UW squad.
Yeah, the posts are being aggressive. They got a tough task at hand. She's doing a great job of rotating them in and out, keeping them fresh so no one's kept getting in foul trouble.
Strother had the pin, but unable to get it there was Romeo. Now into the key there. UW diving after it, and the Portland Pilots will have possession. And a chance to get it down to single digits. So Kaylee Van Loo, point guard again. Now you got the 2-3 from the Huskies. They're gonna make Portland shoot their way back into this game. Skip pass from Zaragoza, kind of dangerous with how active these hands are for UW. Anderson gets the shot blocked, and then a foul underneath by Ashley Gray. So we got a Husky shook up on the play.
Leilani Henson and Chantel
Strother
back into the game for the Huskies.
We'll take a seat. Osahor will check back in for UW. 3.5 minutes remaining. Plum with the hesitation dribble. Collier. Romeo pump fake, steps back, and really tough to defend if you're the Portland Pilots. 9 points for Romeo in just 10 minutes of action. Oh, Anderson. Henson had the lane well jumped at that point, forces it in, and then the foul from behind. It looks like it'll be on Slagan. So second team foul of the quarter, and you see there Van Loo was in position to take another charge.
I think she would have had it too. Unlucky play there.
Up over the top, Plum with a fresh 30. He's gonna pull up from 4 feet beyond the arc, way short with that one. Plum just 6 points, 1 of 7 from the floor. She's gotten most of her production from the free throw line.
Husky's still in that 2-3 zone. It's important the Pilots attack gaps here. Get some good looks.
Van Loo trying to get it into Ashley Gray. Anderson, and she walked. You've got Ashley Heather Coral, and she's her sister who played at USC. You got Heather Coral down on the end there getting a thumb taped up from that. And a big drive from Plum, making it look easy for the Huskies. Pull up from 14 from Anderson. And a jump ball, it'll go UW's way. Some tenacious play from the Huskies.
Darian Slega back into the game for the Pilots to replace Anderson.
Plum against Slega. And now Slega falls down, so Plum wide open. That's automatic points for the University of Washington Huskies. So Portland, who had broken this game down to 10, goes with another scoring drought here, now just under 3 minutes without a point. Slega pulling up from 15 short. Osahor with the rebound and now running the floor. Swung to the corner, here's Henson. Looking for Collier, couldn't get it. Plum, thinking about it. Osahor, and offensive foul as Ashley Gray hits the hardwood.
Offensive foul on the Huskies, number zero, Chantel Osahor, that's her second and the team fourth.
And again, this UW team, one of their strengths is that you've got basically, they go with the three guards, two posts, a traditional setup, but all five players can play the perimeter, and Osahor, they're just got a little too aggressive. Loose ball, Ashley Gray got a hand on it for Portland, but now here's Collier running the floor. Romeo in the corner, but Collier will take it herself, and the lead is now 20 for the Huskies. Zaragoza asking for it, she's gonna have to check herself out of the key. Slega, and Plum jumps that passing lane, and she will finish. Contact and two free throws on the way. She runs herself in under the hoop and she is shaken up. It's that left shoulder. You see Plum there. This University of Washington, loves to get in the passing lane.
At the line to shoot two for the Huskies, number 10, Kelsey Plum.
The zone is causing some problems for the Pilots. I think they were a little not getting looks that they want.
And Plum. It's almost like a layup.
Back in for the Pilots, number 14.
Or Plum, who just comes into this game with all types of accolades. Might be the best player in the nation. And so the senior from Poway, California. Pushing this lead to 22 for Washington, and now here's the last shot for Portland, who has not found an answer for this zone. Now attacking the heart, here's Turley. Lays off to Gray, and she traveled.
Some tough unforced turnovers by the Pilots with a few travels down the stretch against that zone.
Our score at the half, the Washington.
And so at halftime, you have Washington 37, Portland 15. Allison, anything you're seeing there in the first 20 minutes or so?
Pilots, I think when we attack, they attack the rim. They're getting good looks. Unfortunately, that zone really caused some trouble for them. So it will be interesting to see how they attack that if Washington stays in it coming into the second half.
Well, we'll take a break here at the Child Center. When we come back, we've got features for you from Portside with the Pilots. And then we'll have first half stats, all that and more from the Child Center when we return.
Please welcome to the court.
back here at the Childs Center. University of Washington, number 15 in the land, 37. The Portland Pilots, 15 at halftime. Let's take a look at the awesome student athletes we have here at the University of Portland. Not only are they great on the court, but off the court, they've been hitting the books hard as well.
Welcome back to Courtside with the Pilots. I'm your host, Jamie Hudson, and today I am joined by University of Portland Provost and Professor of Education, Dr. Thomas Green. Dr. Green, so happy to have you today. Thank you for joining us.
Well, it's a great pleasure. Thank you, Jamie.
Well, Dr. Green, first we want to start off with talking about the relationship between academics and athletics. How strong is that relationship?
Well, the university's mission is all about the whole person. So if we think about executing the mission well, then we would have a really great relationship between academics and athletics, and that is the case. I think it begins at the top. Scott Lakem is a great advocate for athletics and academics. He hires coaches who also appreciate that mission. And all of us are recognizing the fantastic role that athletics can play in the formation of our students. We also have a great, strong, supportive faculty and incredibly responsible student athletes. So I think the relationship between academics and athletics is very strong.
The overall department GPA last year was 3.26 in the fall and 3.27 in the spring. And our student athletes are taking on some pretty challenging majors across the board. So how impressive is that stat considering the rigorous coursework?
Well, we have athletes that are engaged in biology, mechanical engineering, nursing, psychology, a whole host of majors. In fact, we have athletes that are in all five of the academic units. The stat's impressive. It reflects the work of great faculty and great students and great student athletes. And I'm very pleased with the way the relationship and the mutual respect exists between athletics and academics.
How big of an emphasis does the University of Portland put on undergraduate research, and why is it so important to you to support undergraduate research?
Undergraduate research is very critical because I think we learn best by doing rather than just listening. And we have a number of programs that really focus on experiential kinds of learning. For example, we have internships, we have study abroad options, we have leadership programs, we have clinicals, and of course we have that undergraduate research that you mentioned. We have the Dundon-Berchtold Institute that supports undergraduate research, the Provost's Initiative that supports undergraduate research, and we also have the College of Arts and Sciences Summer Research Program. Examples of this fine work are Callie Vanderwild. She did a marvelous job with looking at the weather stations on campus and the data associated with that. Jeffrey Dunn, he did an amazing piece of work working with Dr. Eleanor Sullivan. They were looking at maternal diet effect.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you, and thank you guys for joining us. That'll do it for this edition of Portside with the Pilots. We'll see you next month.
see what the pilots do to adjust to that.
So it looks like man-to-man defense coming out of the intermission for the Huskies, which is a huge thing for Portland. They just had a lot of trouble moving the basketball against that zone defense. Here's Ashley Gray with the rebound off the Blades miss, and now Plum running the floor yet again for the Huskies. All the way to the corner, Romeo Collier. Back to Romeo one last time, off the front of the rebound. Portland Pilots pushing it up the floor yet again. Van Loo into the key, lost control of it to Blades, one dribble. And back to Van Loo, 17 on the shot clock. Turley and some miscommunication from the Portland Pilots. So Portland, who went a majority of the game committing very few turnovers, at 8 turnovers now for this one. Now here's Plum again, the left hand. And what a mix-up. There's not too many players with that left-hand capability in the women's level for NCAA, and she just continues to mix it up, and Portland cannot give her that driving lane.
No, I think every time she's attacked the rim, she's gone to the left, either finished or got to that free throw line.
And again, Plum, pretty much automatic from 15 feet, hits the first. And again, Plum, 2 for 2. Blades running to the corner. Here's Turley, dribble drive, contact. Collier fighting with a rebound from Turley, and now Corral, here she goes. Plum might have got away with a walk there. Loose ball, Van Loo comes away with it. Turley, Van Loo, catcher's ready to shoot, and said Julie Spencer trying to go baseline, and it'll go the other way. So Cheryl Sorensen trying to get the hand check called on that drive. And said the Huskies going to take it the other way. Spencer, third personal foul, second team foul for the Portland Pilots. And now Ashley Gray wins the battle underneath for Portland, and they go running the other way. And a moving screen called, and it looks like Ashley Gray shook up on the play. Going to be called for a moving screen. Not too sure about that one.
Osafor kind of pushed her way through there. I don't know if I'd want to be on the other end of that.
So Ashley Gray collecting herself, and now here's Plum. Plum with the right hand. Try to find Heather Coral, and that goes out of bounds. So Van Loo, as UW in a rare scoring drought of their own, 0 field goals in the last 3 minutes or so. Turley. Van Loo now gets it into Gray, who draws the instant double team. Single digits on the shot clock. Van Loo, a rare three-pointer from her. Loose ball. It's kind of weird to see Holly Blade shading her towards that baseline. I think it's just instinctual at this point.
Yeah, especially a left-handed player. That's where she wants to go.
Spencer's saying don't send it in. And you've got this UW team that is doubling every post-entry. Turley can't attack. Blades keeping it alive. And a loose ball foul on Turley. And she can't believe it. And that'll take us to the media timeout. Washington with a 43-19 lead over the Pilots and possession when we come back.
Portland would like to take this moment to thank Nike for their continued support of
Back here at the Child Center, where no one has scored for the last 3.5 minutes on either side of the floor. 43-19 right now. Both these teams just bone dry from the field. Oh, of their last 10 combined. And so Portland Pilots shooting 7 of 40. UW not much better, 13 of 40. Both these teams, Allison, struggling to find a rhythm.
Yeah, it's definitely a dry spell. Interesting to see who's going to get things going.
So here's Plum, who hasn't been shy about attacking the basket. Hosahor. And now the first bucket in quite a while for either team from Chantel Hosahor. Van Loo. Julie Spencer calling for it on the pick and pop. Now swung to Blades, 15 on the shot clock. Van Loo had a little bit of space. He's gonna pull up from three, no good. Blades offensive rebound. Couldn't get the second chance to fall. Now here's Plum, 2-on-1. And then calls an audible there to Romeo, and now Portland Pilots with five back on defense. They find Collier underneath, and she'll get fouled.
Holly Blade still scoreless for the Pilots here.
Slagan. Inside to Gray, in and out for the Portland Pilots, so their woes continue. And here's Plum. Into the corner, Romeo, the natural pick from Plum, no good. And here's Van Loo with the defensive rebound, and now Portland going to run. Looking to pull up, here's Ashley Gray. Into the key, Slaga for three, yes! Nothing but the bottom of the net for Darian Slaga. A sophomore from Prescott Valley, Arizona, breaking the scoring drought for Portland. Doing well off the bench, now with 8 points. Corral's one in.
Heather Corral.
Slaga reverse lay-in, and she'll shoot two on the other end as Portland has found that they've got to run with this UW team if they're going to have any opportunities on the other end of the floor.
Yeah, they've been successful in transition when they've gotten looks.
At the line to shoot two for the Pilots, number 32, Darian Slaga.
So Slaga come to the line. 9 for 10 this season, make that 10 of 11.
Back into the game for the Huskies, number one, Hannah Johnson.
Collier Corral will take his seat. Johnson and Henson back in for the Dogs. So Slaga will look to be the first Pilot in double digits with that free throw. 10 points for Darian Slaga.
She's really provided a spark for the Pilots off the bench. Let's see if she can keep it going.
Plum. Got that high screen. Here's Johnson. Inside. Far side now, Romeo. Pump fake, no good. Gray with the rebound. Slaga repeats from beyond the arc. So 13 points for Slaga. Hosahor off the dribble finds Romeo from long range. And now a 52-27 UW advantage. Slaga pull up, and she's got the hot hand for the Portland Pilots. Three of her last three. And again, the last 8 Portland Pilot points coming from Slaga. And there is Henson.
Henson for three.
So Henson responds, and now here's Slaga again. She'll pass off to Van Loo and then try to get it back. Now here's Slaga, working one-on-one, why not?
14 on the shot clock. Spencer stepping out from 18, and it falls. So the Portland Pilots get something going at the end of the third quarter. Johnson, Henson, Osahor. Double team, Romeo in the corner again, and connects.
Gosh, she's great at finding those open shooters out on the outside.
Yeah, Osahor just putting on a passing clinic right now. 16 rebounds, 11 points. And Romeo now getting into double digits for Washington. And Slaga again has herself a third quarter. 58-33. Final shot here for UW. Plum driving baseline. Romeo from NBA range hits again. Oh my goodness. Back at the Child Center, and here's Darian Slaga. Just absolutely went off in the third quarter. 17 points, 6 of 9 from the field for the game, and you can see Slaga getting it done. Baseline, she's getting it done from beyond the arc, and really, that was what the Portland Pilots needed to keep this game civil.
Yeah, and she's got a tough matchup down on the defensive end. She's been guarding Plum. Doing a pretty good job of keeping her not getting shots open, but we need her to keep a hot hand this fourth quarter.
And so you have Osahor with 11 points for UW on the floor. Romeo off the court right now. She has 18 points leading all scorers, 6 of 12 from the field, and she was matching Slaga point for point as Julie Spencer in and out. And then Ashley Gray is going to get called for the foul there, but she's the one who comes shaking up. And now Osahor with a limp as well. So some physical play underneath, and Portland Pilots kind of knew what they were getting into with this UW team that just does so many things well from the inside and out. And you can see everyone 1 through 5 on the floor can handle the ball for this Husky squad. And we've got a walk. So the Portland Pilots doing a good job fighting through those dribble handoffs. Van Loo running the show. You've got Van Loo, Blades, Spencer Slaga, and Gray out on the floor for the Portland Pilots. Van Loo attacking the heart. Blades from long, long distance. Can't get it to fall. Plum with the rebound and the fast break. Finds Henson in the corner. Short. Rebound Balgoza. Now Osahor. Dribble drive. Stops at 12 feet, finds Johnson underneath. No foul call after some contact, and UW will keep it. And inside now, Henson, a quick hitter off the inbounds play. Drawn up perfectly, And you got a team this well put together like UW. You can spend some practice time putting in cheeky little plays like that. Slaga, heat check, no good. And now Plum running the floor is Melgoza and Henson. And now Plum, it's down by 18, but they can make this manageable. Now Plum falling down. Here's Melgoza. And Mike Neighbors will call a timeout, and it'll be extended into the media. So we'll take a break here. Washington with the ball, 15 seconds on the shot clock when we return. Back here at the Childs Center, the University of Washington Huskies ranked number 15 in the nation with a 63-35 lead, but the Portland Pilots have been holding tough defensively. Cody Barton here with Allison Severs. Allison, this Portland Pilot team has been really propped up too by the offensive play of Darian Slaga.
Yeah, it's been huge this second half. Got to keep it going. Their defense, though, getting stops, it's what they want. Now got to take advantage on the offensive end.
So Plum attacking the basket there out of the media timeout. Spencer picking up her fourth personal foul, second team foul for Portland. You see just a little give and go action. Could draw that one up in the backyard.
And Kate Anderson also into the game for the Pilots to replace Slaga.
So Kate Anderson checking in for Slaga. Zaragoza in for Spencer. You got to rest your score. That's one of the things you got to develop here. So even though Darian Slaga, the only person scoring the basketball right now for Portland, hopefully Carissa Turley, who's been their go-to so far this year, can get activated in this fourth quarter, help Slaga out while she catches her breath. Eight on the shot clock for Portland. Inside, Van Loo touches all of the rim before finding the bottom of the net. Plum, little push off there. Henson, and on the floor is Turley. The Portland Pilots getting aggressive in the over and back call.
Great hustle right there.
Court violation against the Huskies.
Hopefully this is a little spark that the Pilots need to get something going.
And you see this Portland Pilot team not passive on the defensive end. You just can't during that run of the third quarter. Checks back in for the Huskies. She has 18 points. Plum with 22. Just 5 of 15 from the floor, though. Osahor finds Romeo. Back to Osahor on the block. Zaragoza gets a hand in the passing lane. 9 on the shot clock for the Huskies. Osahor calling back for it once again. Gray with the body. So Osahor able to put the ball on the floor, and that spin move causes Ashley Gray to kind of push back here at the end. You see just following her as she fades away, and that's kind of one of those toss-up calls.
Tough D, tough break.
So Gray with her fourth personal foul, four team fouls for Portland. Van Loo taking it to the net, no good. Now on the break, Romeo, the lead pass from Plum, can't finish. And here's Turley, and the Portland Pilots a 4-on-2. Turley going around Zaragoza, can't finish her herself, and there here's Zaragoza, and she'll get called with the travel.
Now it looks like a jump ball.
So a jump ball there, Zaragoza and Osahor.
Gives it back to the Huskies.
Plum, Romeo, Ashley Gray, again, another tough defensive assignment. Does a good job that time, gets the rebound for Portland, and now they're pushing. Turley pulls up from 17, off the glass, the bank open on Sundays here in North Portland. Plum, again, now she goes to the right. You just can't stop her either direction.
She can do a little bit of everything.
And so that'll take us into another media timeout. 4:51 remaining here. Kelsey Plum with free throws when we come back.
Saturday night for Comet Superhero Night and to take on the University of Colorado. Tip-off is set for 7 p.m.
Cody Barton here with Allison Severs as we have the Portland Pilots trailing the University of Washington into the fourth quarter, 4:51 remaining in this one. Kelsey Plum to shoot two free throws off the Turley foul.
At the line to shoot the double bonus for the Huskies.
So Plum, who is 10 of 11 from 15 feet today, hits on that one, extending this lead for UW. Two of two in Washington now, 72-40 advantage over the Portland Pilots.
Julie Spencer's
checked into the game as Jawan Carrington also on the floor for Portland. They're facing this 2-3 zone from the Huskies. Turley, Anderson, high post. Julie Spencer tried to find her buddy and taken away by Plum. Osahor, Malgoza, backdoor cut, Plum finds Romeo in the corner, and that's automatic for University of Washington. 21 points from Romeo, 24 from Plum. That was her sixth assist. Turley now attacking the paint and converts. So the Portland Pilots just trying to get themselves some momentum heading into their home game. Inter-city rivalry between Portland State as Kelsey Plubb dribbles through the Portland Pilot defense. She's trying to get her season average of 30. She looks determined. She's got 26 right now. Julie Spencer off the front of the rim and in.
Julie Spencer.
So here's Plum again. Portland man-to-man defense. Osahor from beyond the arc, no good. Portland Pilots scrambling. Couple of passes in the backcourt now. Here's Van Loo. Into Carrington. Quick pass to the perimeter. Turley. 13 on the shot clock. Have the overload and see if now someone will attack for Portland to break through. Turley, Anderson, four on the shot clock, has to pull up, draws the foul from Melgoza. So Anderson will go to the free throw line to shoot two. And successful on the first. Now Anderson comes into this game shooting 75%, or excuse me, just 33%, rather. So that'll help up her average. Only her seventh and eighth attempts of the season. And she'll go 2 of 2. So Romeo working off the Johnson screen, and then Carrington tried to head, but goes 0 for 2 on that trip. 7 3-pointers for Romeo this afternoon for all 21 of her points. Some extremely efficient play. She's got Kelsey Plumb to thank for a lot of them. She's just been wheeling and dealing around the perimeter.
Huskies back in that 2-3 zone.
Slaga off the back of the rim. Weiberg, who's checked into the game for the first time for UW, couldn't get a hold of it. And then the no-look pass from Slaga, taken away by UW. Melgoza, Weiberg, good.
Mackenzie Weber for three.
Swung around, here's Turley, 15 on the shot clock. Anderson getting aggressive. Turley thought about it, goes to the elbow. Here's the freshman again, not afraid to stroke it from 17.
Pilots bench contributing a lot for this team. Anderson, Slega, and Turley.
Romeo, dribble drive here. Underneath. Take it away from Henson, and here's Anderson again. Under a minute here. Anderson, dribble drive. Weiberg will get the foul.
Husky's foul on number 42, Mackenzie Weiberg, her first.
Just good to see a freshman getting involved late in this game. Doesn't care about the score, doesn't care about who she's playing. She's showing Cheryl Sorensen just how effective she can be at this next level.
Yeah, despite the scoreboard, hopefully this game's gonna allow some of these younger kids to build some confidence going into the next stretch of games for the Pilots.
So Johnson unable to collect it for Washington. It means Portland Pilots will get it back with 54.8 seconds left in this one. Three-pointer, Slaga, good. Continuing to have it dialed in. 22 points now for the sophomore. Romeo driving against Carrington, misses. Johnson will get it back. Fresh 30 for UW. Romeo, dribble drive. Weber. Spin move. And off of Turley, the block there for the senior. Romeo looking for three-pointer number 8 in and out. And then Johnson, she'll get her own attempt at scoring 3 points in a possession with that and one. So Carrington picks up the personal foul, and then completing the three-point play is Johnson. Shot clock turned off. Portland Pilots looking for this last possession here before we head into the locker rooms, and UW could think about completing their road trip at Grand Canyon as Alslega. She's earned it so far. She'll get to go to the charity stripe one last time. And then for Portland, they've got Portland State coming up on Wednesday, so they really can't think too much about this tough matchup against UW they just had.
Yeah, it's always a tough matchup against crosstown rivals Portland State. Hopefully these girls can carry on some of this confidence into the next game, especially defensively, being able to slow down a top team in the Huskies.
So Romeo will dribble it out. And your final score here at the Child Center, number 15, Washington 83, Portland 53, your final. And your Portland Pilots will be next seen in action November 30th, 7 p.m. against Portland State, in-town rivals. You can find that on the W.TV. Allison, any parting thoughts before we sign off?
It was great to be back on the bluff, I'll tell you that. I think the Pilots, small victories, like Coach Cheryl said, to take away from this game, and I think they have some to take away and talk about and move forward.
Kelsey Plum leads all scorers with 26. Darian Slega for the Portland Pilots off of 7 of 12 from the floor with 24 points for Portland. I'm Cody Barton, and with Allison Sievers and all of us at the University of Portland, we say thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time.